Okay, this is right. Yeah. All right, this is a tough one. I'm almost out of resources. Parkour, all the lot of them. We have a situation now, don't we?
Meryl's in danger. Take out the enemy before they get to her.
Why are they so beefy? Oh, goodness. Easy to just drop something useful. Oh god. Where's my syringe? Pop it. Meryl. Wow, they take almost a full clip to kill. Am I supposed to leave it? Oh, I did it.
Meryl.
Snake.
Are you ready to fight more? Because you are going to fight more. Look at that scope Desert Eagle she has, that's awesome.
Snake, run!
I know your wavelength. It brings back memories.
It can't be.
Johnny?
Johnny!
Meryl!
Oh, we've got a problem. Look at that new 3D model.
They cry for battle. Let me hear you scream, howl, roar from the very depths of your soul.
Gotta shoot the doll of Mantis.
What's this?
His controllers in another port. That's just unfair. Here's the plan now. I'm gonna get Meryl to go to sleep. Meryl! God damn it. Yep, time to do. Oh, that's not it. No, I don't want to turn the system off. And now you gotta go back. So hang on.
Autocon, what's going on? I can't move.
You can't move? What the heck did you? Oh, Snake. Did you set the controller number to something other than one?
No.
Let me guess. You thought back to your battle with Psycho Mantis and figured the same tactic would actually work again, right?
Well, I...
Nice try, Snake. But this time the controller number has to be one, or else you can't control your actions.
What the hell? Whose dumb idea was that?
Don't look at me! I'm sorry, but it's simply not going to work this time around.
How do I cut this? Why does he use my syringe?
Snake! Respond! Snake! Snake!
Yikes. Right, don't use my syringe. Use my syringe. But make sure I've got health. Now let's see if we can put Meryl to sleep. I am gonna use the psycho. Drebin, need your shot. Compatible with the psycho, let's see. There we go. Huh. Meryl, wake up. Or go to sleep. Wow.
Snake? Snake!
Oh, that sucks. Okay. This is gonna be the new van fight for me, isn't it? Drebin, why don't you sell good things like items? Look, items, Drebin. Just sell like items that make me feel good. So it is super dope.
Even if she tries to hurt you, Meryl's not acting of her own free will. Don't do anything to hurt her.
Oh. Yep, Sara's about to fall off. No. Okay. What if I use CQC Meryl and use the syringe on her?
Don't hurt Meryl. She can't take it.
I got it by mistake. Okay, hang on. CQC. Oh. Holy shit, that's a lot of things going on. Going! I didn't realize this was a non-lethal shotgun now. Yes indeed, come on. Why did that blow up? Where is it? Got it. Is it an item? Nope, it's a weapon. Alright. Machine gun, you gotta go. Sorry, doll. Come on!
What happened? Snake? Snake!
Come the fuck on. This is not cool. I wish you can just buy like ammo quickly. Well, that's taking care of Meryl for a bit. Why can't I walk? Sorrowed off us. Because Meryl's being controlled by the Mantis doll. But everything else is controlled by the Sorrow doll.
Even if she tries to hurt you, Meryl's not acting of her own free will. Don't do anything to hurt her.
Yeah, that's my operator. Sorry, Meryl. For your own good. Get that Sorrow doll out of the way. Got no control over goons. Oh, hang my leg. Got it. Don't actually know how to beat her. Otacon, can you tell me what to do? Please.
I've got an idea. What if you use those puppets to turn the tables on the beast? Control her instead.
Use the puppets.
It's worth a try, at least. First, select one in the item window. Then, press the attack button to shoot out a ghost, just like a weapon. If the ghost hits its target, it's showtime.
You got it.
All that snake? Go on, take her for a spin.
Oh.
Snake, I'd be willing to bet that the fucking
Oh, sorry. Back. Weapon. I'm still gonna keep the railgun on and the operator. Hey. Damn it. Let she go. Oh God. I've never done that before, I don't think. So many blades. One of them could have killed me. Oh, noxious gas. Ew, hands. Man, Snake didn't care about that one. Gratuitous boob shot. This is one of those poses girls can do. Like, I've never seen a man do that pose ever. Man, your bodysuit is different. That's not how boobs work. Or maybe it is. Maybe Kojima's put a lot of effort into it. That was uneventful.
No. Get out of my body. For Forgive me.
Into gameplay.
Set me free!
Whoop, time to back up. Don't like that screaming sound, it freaks me out. Actually. There we go. That's actually what it sounds like. It sounds like a big verbal re. You did it, Snake. You beat all five of them. Or four of them. There was only four. Oh boy. Now what? From MGS1.
Mantis. You don't seem to believe your own eyes. Very well. I will show you the power of the world's greatest mind reader and psychokinesis. I'm stunned by reading your personality.
You have no other save datas?
What? Where is your data? Where is it saved? Memory card. Your skills have improved, or rather, your hardware. How about this, then? Witness my psychokinesis. Put your controller.
I'm not going to do that. That was some goofy bullshit.
The spirit of the warrior will always be with you.
Sorrow. I did it.
So, you bested the last beast. That doll you just picked up lets you manipulate anybody who's got nanomachines in them. Sounds like something the devil's cooked up, if you ask me. Mantis came from South America. She was born and raised in a country racked by never-ending civil wars. Her village was attacked by enemy forces and burned to the ground. This was when she was still a little girl. Hunted by enemy death squads, she was separated from her family.
She barely
managed to escape with her life. Ended up in the basement of this one building. It was full of corpses that had been dumped there.
Almost that's unfortunate.
Been tortured to death. She was petrified with fear. And then, she heard the sound of heavy boots on the floor above her, followed by shrieking screams. The kind that would make every hair on your body stand straight up. She had stumbled across a makeshift torture chamber. Somebody'd locked the door, and she was trapped. It was dark, it was dank, and it was full of a wretched stench. She couldn't sleep with the screams of torture victims all around her. All she could do was sit curled up in one corner of the room, trembling. A week passed, then 10 days. She managed to keep hydrated by drinking the filthy water pooled up on the floor, but there was no food.
She's gotta eat the people.
Being trapped in that kind of place, half crazy from hunger, did a serious number on her mind. Did you know female mantises eat their mates? The screams went on day and night.
She's she got to eat ears, the people.
But it didn't help. And then she was saved by a little black mantis that taught her how to block out the screams, how to plug up her inner ears.
What the hell are you talking about?
I'm saying, Snake, that when she couldn't stand the hunger any longer, she started feeding on the corpses.
There we go.
But only the male ones.
She ate their dicks.
She didn't realize who was doing it. In her mind, it was a female mantis devouring her mates.
No, it wasn't.
It was like one big twisted waking dream.
That's not how it works.
There was no mantis, of course. It was all a hallucination. Nothing more than some story spun by another person she created inside. Her unstable mind was what made her so vulnerable. Later, they ripped out what was left of her psyche with drugs and hypnosis, and implanted the persona of Psycho Mantis. It wasn't her will that controlled the B&Bs. It was Psycho Mantis, half assimilated into her soul, pulling the strings. Screaming Mantis was just another puppet.
Anyway, how ironic.
She survived several weeks down in that hellhole and finally got back to the surface. But the screams in her head didn't subside. They would always be with her. Only this time, they weren't real. The inner earplugs didn't work anymore. The black mantis had disappeared. There was no place left to escape. Which is why she was always screaming, to drown out the ones in her own head. But it's over now. You freed Mantis from that dark nightmare.
The last of the beasts.
You got it, pal. Well, I'm done playing storyteller for a while. Now get going. GW is waiting. And this time, you get to make up the ending.
Cool. I did it. Whew. Wait, what about Meryl? You're just gonna leave her and Johnny's corpse there? Ta-da!
Where's Johnny?
Oh, we have a problem.
They're here.
Three shots. Going to hurt a lot.
Go!
I thought this would be the Mr. and Mrs. Smith moment, you know. You're not fooling anyone with your slow walks.